Hey guys, what's up? This is Groovus X Roger. I hope you enjoyed this playthrough. Now this is a final thoughts summary going home tips, and I'm aiming this right at the solo player, people who are on the fence like I was about buying Descent. Can you play it solo? Hopefully from that you saw. So for the next 2 or 3 minutes, I really would like your attention, full attention for what I'm trying to convey. And what am I trying to convey is this. It's the element of surprise. And that's, I think, why gamers, me, you, video games, or even board games, we like that element of surprise. And I think by giving the Overlord, Baylor, whoever your Overlord is, an automated one, brains in the form of dice, coming up with strategies, and then letting dice or fate decide what happens in the dungeon. I think that's why that this works. So if you didn't watch the whole thing, but like an example, remember when we, at the beginning of the game, spiders, we grabbed one of Baylor's brains or a die, and we said, okay, on a 1 to 3, let's come up with this strategy. The spiders pack up and back. That way the heroes have to work, to, you know, all their movement to get back. 4 to 6, we use another brain or die, and we are gonna assign each spider. We roll, and then whatever comes up, you know, they got assigned here, I believe. So right there, that kind of was game-changing. You know, who knows what would have happened if they were on the back or there. So that kind of changed the ebb and flow of the game. Remember back here with the goblins, they had to bring the prisoners over to Splig to interrogate. So we came up with another strategy, 1 to 3. Two of the goblins are going to break off and come up and reinforce the Shadow Dragon and spiders while the other two go get prisoners. So that was on a 1 to 3, 4 to 6. They all just went for prisoners. And if you remember, we even went further where the master went. These goblins laid down some heavy damage there. Who knows how that would have, you know, churned out. Another time during that game, these doors were open, this was open. The Shadow Dragon was here, and Syndrel was right here. And we came up with that strategy where, okay, the Shadow Dragon on a 1 to 3 would attack. On a 4 to 6, it would retreat back with the goblins to the prison and just pack up and wait for the heroes. And again, you could change that number to whatever you want. So my point is this, even with other, you know, many other scenarios that I've played so far, I've done this. I think that's why this is fun, that we like that element of surprise with the game. And when you do this automated overlord thing or give him brains or whatever, so, and you come up with these little scenarios or strategies. Okay, well, if this comes up, they're going to do this. If this comes up, they're going to do this, and even take it further. Okay, if this comes up, they're going to do this. Every time you play the scenario, it's not going to play out the same. And then, you know, by rolling the dice, of course, that's going to totally change. So that's what I want to convey to you guys. If you're thinking about it, yes, I think this game, it's pretty streamlined as the Overlord. And that's why I think it works. And now we didn't touch on these event cards, and you have to play these on the hero's turn. So let's say like it was a time sensitive mission with Splig, and you know you would probably want to save Tripwire that trips up the heroes and makes them lose their movement. So you may want to assign at the beginning of the game the Overlord might want to save those. So let's just say on a 1 to 5, it would not trigger, and on a 6, it would. Where at the end of the game, it would trigger because, you know, you would use that. So hopefully this little playthrough helped you. And just remember, it's the element of surprise. That's what I'm trying to convey with the dice. And, you know, and if you decide to do this on your own, you know, just remember that. When you're playing, come up with, you know, some scenarios that an Overlord would do. Assign them to some of the brains or the dice of the Overlord and play that out. And I think you'll see that that's why it's that element of surprise that keeps this game really fresh. And remember, you would just do the same with these. So you would assign these on the hero's turn if they trigger every time the hero moves. And then I think that's everything I wanted to say about that I wanted to tell you guys. And hopefully that makes your decision up if you want to get, you know, Descent for yourself and run it solo. Or actually run it with your friends as heroes and then do, you know, that and see how it comes out. The other thing that I was toying with, and I'm going to be going into the quest vault on FFG's site to create some quests, where I took this from my Mage Knight board game, but the heroes would have life force. Basically, you know how a hero can always keep getting revived. If it gets knocked down, it can stand up. Well, say maybe this would be a good variant or would complement doing this automated, you know, dice thing. where the heroes would only have so much life force. So say Cinderella got knocked down. She got knocked down quite a bit in the last scenario. When she stood up or got revived, you take away a life force. You know, if that would happen again, this is the last one. If it would happen again, she would be out of the game. So what I'm trying, you know, so you could try something like that where they have a limited amount of life force, as I've coined that phrase. I'm out of here. Just remember, if you pick it up, I guess the method is take a look at what you're dealing with. Come up with a couple really good logical, you know, paths. You know, throw some of the Overlord's brains into it, assign it a role, and you'll see that every time you play, it's going to be a different game, and it has that element of surprise that we all like. Hopefully, at least some comments, ask questions, love talking to people. Hopefully you enjoyed this, and so happy gaming, everyone, and I will talk to you soon. Bye-bye.